You are going to love this cooking segment. One of my favorite things is the butterfly fried smelts. I absolutely love them. I always call them Newcastle smelts. Because when I'd go to restaurants in Newcastle, like Pegley's or the Crane Room or Medora's, they're light, they're opened up. They're almost like eating a potato chip. And I saw some smelts and I bought the bag. They're cleaned, heads off. And I tried to make them at home and they just didn't taste right. So I was discussing this with my friend Anna from Laracas. And she says, well, you have to remove that spine. Lights go on, and I figured out that secret. So I've been removing the spine, and boy, are these delicious. You are going to love this recipe. It's really easy. Smelts are not just for Christmas Eve. You can make these every day of the year, and everyone will love them. So let's get started, and we're gonna make the butterflied fried smelts today. For this recipe, you'll need 1 pound bag of frozen clean smelts, 2 eggs beaten with 1/8 cup of water, 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 1 cup of cornmeal, 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of Cajun seasoning, optional, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of fresh ground black pepper, canola or peanut oil for frying, 1 gallon size storage bag, 1/2 cup of fresh chopped parsley for garnish, and lemon wedges. I've already cleaned some of the smelts. There's probably about 50 to 60 smelts per pound bag, 2 to 3 inches long. It's a little tedious, but once you get the hang of it, it moves very quickly. So what we'll do is start with a fork. Now you take the back, it's already partially opened, and then I just fling it open all the way with the fork. And then beginning at the fatter part where the head was, you just use the fork tine to take it and strip out that spine. See right there? And then I just lay them on a paper towel to dry. So now that we've gotten the bones out of there, the easiest way to do it is almost shake and bake style. I just get a bigger bag and I like the fine cornmeal. So use a cup of that, cup of flour. Then I'm going to use, now I like a little spice. So I put some of my slap your mama in. You do not have to do that if you don't want any spice, but I do like the taste of the garlic. So I'm using garlic powder and then about 1/2 teaspoon or so of salt. You can always add more when they come out of the fryer. And then of course, you know me, I love my fresh ground pepper. So now we just take that and shake it all up to get it mixed thoroughly. I believe this is the easiest way to do it rather than on a plate or in a bowl. And then you just throw it away. All right, so you can add milk if you'd like, but I think just a little bit of water to the egg wash, and just make sure you beat it really well so it's real light and airy. See all the bubbles? You just want that really foamy. Okay. Now, I usually do this about 10 at a time, a dozen at a time, and then I just drop them right there in the wash and let them soak around there a little bit. And then pull them out one at a time. Try to leave them open, let them drip, and then you just drop them right in the bag. I mean, it's a little messy, not that messy. We'll do it that way. My hands, ugh. All right, and then you just go. And use the finer cornmeal, because it sticks a little better. There you go. Now we'll take them out and you open them up. See, and they're all covered nicely. And you just lay them right back down on another paper towel. You do go through quite a few paper towels here, but make sure that both sides, they didn't close up and they get all the good stuff on them. I'm gonna use canola oil to fry this, but peanut oil works well too. And you want the oil temperature to be about 160 to 175. And if you don't have a thermometer to measure the heat, you can also use a wooden spoon and just stick it in. And when you see the bubbles form, that means you have temperature good enough for frying. So now we have our oil ready to go. I like to start with the skin side down. So there we go. Throw these in. They're only going to be about 2 minutes on this side and about a minute on the other side. These cook very quickly. You don't want to crowd them. And the minute you see them start to brown, we'll flip them. Restaurant quality smelts, and they were super easy. I absolutely love these. Lemon, a little bit of parsley on top, and you are good to go. Now, some people like the cocktail sauce, but I think it fights with the fresh, clean taste of the smelts. So I squeezed some lemon, and you know what else I like for a little more heat? I like the green Tabasco sauce. And I put that on a little bit of mine. And I just think it makes them that much more fun. Now remember, if you don't want the hot sauce, you don't have to add it. Mmm. These are delicious. Great for a crowd. Make them in batches just for a few people. But people that say they don't like smelts, make sure they try these because they are going to love them. And with smelts, I think a nice cold beer is in order as a pairing. I'm using the Modelo Especial. I really like the Mexican beers. And this is perfect palate cleanser to wash down those delicious smelts. Mm. If you need the recipe, just go to my website, CaseyMaloneShow.com, for the fried butterflied smelts. You are going to love them as much as I do. Mm. Cheers.